Okay, this is all David Crowder today. You're gonna like it. Right here.
Thank you.
Grace means just a gift that we don't deserve, that we're forgiven, and that God says that we're perfect together, we believe. And I was reading in Galatians this morning, and Paul, who wrote a big chunk of the New Testament, actually criticized his switch legs. Peter was like one of Jesus' closest friends. So Peter messed this up, guys. So don't beat yourself up if you mess it up. But what Paul does is he kind of calls Peter out on trying to stick with the law rather than just being forgiven by grace. Okay, so let's go down and do push-ups. Push-ups, everybody? So there was a law that was created in the Old Testament, and it gave tons and tons of rules. And the real purpose of the law was to show us that we could never do things perfectly. We were gonna mess up. So no, even if we mess up with just one of those laws, we've messed up. So here's what it says, what he says about grace. Let me just be sure I'm in the right spot here. It says, okay, I'm almost there. He says, I make myself guilty if I should rebuke the old system I already tore down. So he's saying to Peter, you're going back to the laws. We've already torn that down. The laws isn't it anymore. He says, so I died to the law so that I might live for God. I have been crucified with Christ. I myself no longer live, but Christ lives in me. Okay, let's lay on our backs, bent knees, alternate cross crunch. So he's saying, the law doesn't matter. I put the law to rest, and now I've crucified the old way I used to live, and I live in Christ lives in me. And then he says, says, so I live my life in this earthly body by trusting in the Son of God who loved me and gave himself for me. I am not one of those who treats the grace of God as meaningless. For if we could be saved by keeping the law, then there was no need for Christ to die. Did you guys hear that? If we think we have to live and follow the law, why did they send Jesus? Jesus was sent to forgive us. All right, guys, that's important stuff, right? Keep going. Four two. Push it down. Four here. Okay? And water. explains Satan in his book called 1 Peter. He says he's like a lion prowling around, just looking for someone to attack, to pounce on. Right here. So we need to be aware, guys, that that's true. But the song says, run, devil, run. Not this world. You're not taking me down, Satan. No chance. And so then the question is, okay, if I say that, what can we do to set ourselves up with a barrier around us, barrier of animals, those things so much tougher than a lion, what can we do to set ourselves up so he can't attack us, right? Be careful, don't drop your head, don't run your back. Shoulders back and down, back to biceps. Knees slightly bent, core tight, shoulders back and down. And guys, what you can do to set yourself up so that Satan, he can try, but you've got a shield around you. And that is to ask God to fill you up so much with his loving truth that there's no crack. Ask him to show you a crack. Do I have a crack in my armor that Satan can use to push in? If so, God, help me to patch that crack. What can I do? Two more. And now then go to triceps. Again, right here. Back flat, shoulders back and down, neck long. And then you can say, well, how do I get so filled up with God's love and truth, right? It could always be that, well, then how, and how, and how? Here's what it is, guys. Spend time with him. I literally said to God this morning when I woke up and I was sitting with my Bible, I didn't say this to God. You guys, pull your bands up here. And we're going to do it as an option. These bands don't have to be used, but if you want, you can use them for squats. Here's what I said. I said, God, I felt kind of distant lately. I want to feel you more. He goes, Michelle, how am I supposed to fill you up if you're not sitting with my word that I gave you every morning and you're not talking to me every day throughout your day? You know what? I've been busy lately and I've been not spending every morning in my Bible, or if I do, it's not enough time to really settle in. And so he convicted my heart. But you know what? Talk to God. Say, God, what is it? What can I do to be more filled with your presence, more protected by you, so I can go out? And for you, it could be something different. For me, I've been letting busyness pull me away in the morning after not settling in with my Bible. Okay? Devil's real, but we can say, run, devil, run, not this girl. Okay? But you need God's help. All right? So now, take your band. How you guys all feel? I'm kind of refreshed. Right here.
I got a green one.
Right here. Pull it up. And then shin taps. I want you to go here kind of as fast as you can, okay? I'm going to turn the music up. Core tight. Arms engaged. I want to see those muscles in your arms working. Big arm movements.
I'm trying to give that.
not to share. This song says, shout loud until the walls come down, because we've already won. And if you don't know the story in the Bible, you might be like, what in the world is that? Switch legs. After you do 12, you're back to 12 spots. Okay? Well, there's a story in the Bible where, and somebody here, correct me if I get any of the names wrong here, where the Israelites are coming, they've just crossed and they're trying to take over Jericho. So it's after they've crossed over, right? Yeah, it's after they've crossed over. They're trying to take over the city of Jericho. God has promised them this city, and so they go in prayer. What do we do? Squats. Here's what God tells them to do. He tells a lot of specifics about how they line up, but they should walk around the gated area of Jericho 7 times and then start hooting and hollering. That's the battle plan that he had for them. They were not super comfortable with this plan, but they had a lot of trust in the God who gave them this weird plan. And so they do it. Now go back to lunges again. 12, 12, and 12. Keep volunteering, guys. And so it says, let's shout because the walls are going to come down because we've already won. What does that look like? What does it mean to you, we've already won? You have any thoughts on that? What does it mean, we've already won?
It's finished.
It's finished. The cross finished it, right? We won at the cross. We're forgiven.
Switch. I answered and I'm counting.
She's giving him the teacher's pat.
Just saying.
Andy, what does it look like to you when I say we've already won? Like you've won. What does that mean to you? And you can say I don't know.
Don't be nerdy.
Oh. What does it mean to you? You've already won.
Spots? 12 spots?
I can't do the number. Jesus, full of grace, and that's butter.
Andy said a very true statement. He said, no matter how much of a knucklehead I am, no, but can we all relate to that, the knuckleheads? He said, God's grace, I'm forgiven, right?
Right.
One. That's good stuff. Okay, we're doing squats now, guys. So just go throughout your day with this feeling kind of more of peace and gratitude, right? Gratitude. Okay, we're going to put it underneath our foot, and we're going to do side bends right here. You need to come down low on that band and pull to the side. Pull to the side, okay? All right, so guys, I always say I live life like I'm watching a replay of a football game. If I know my team wins, the fumbles, the turnovers, the interceptions, they don't get to me because I know my team wins, right? We've won, right?
Yeah.
I guess I should have brought a football since it's the Super Bowl. It's the Super Bowl tomorrow. We might. Let's just see. Who wants the Rams in here? Who's the Rams? Who wants the Rams? Any Patriot fans here?
We're in Colorado, right?
There's no center.
No. Switch sides.
The bad referee call just shows we're human.
Yes.
We are not God.
Oh, yeah. All right, so keep going, guys, right there. I'm going to actually work out with you guys again a little bit here. All right,
here we go. Shout loud until the walls come down. Shout loud until the walls come down. Shout loud until the walls come down. Shout loud.
Yeah. Bye.
freedom.
Tight. We're working like everything you got. Okay? Everything you got. Pushing it back. Pushing it back. The bottom of your foot facing back. 4, 3, 2, 1. Whew. Share about the same amount on the other leg and then go back to the center. Okay? Alright, so follow her. We're gonna do each other leg and then each leg one more time. I'll tell you, I'm one who I hear songs. I hear them when I'm talking to people, I hear the music. So music can either distract me because it grabs my attention, or it can really minister to me because I listen to it. And that song was just saying, "We love you, Lord, we love you." And Jeff was asked a super powerful question at lunch 2 days ago. He said, "How are you doing with worshiping God?" Now, worshiping God doesn't just mean worship in a church service. This is our worship time. What worship really means, if you look at the real meaning of it, is to lay surrender before God in awe of what he did. When's the last time you were in awe of what God did for you? And you just thanked him. And you just said, "Thank you for loving me. I love you too, and I can't imagine my days without you." That's worship, guys. It doesn't mean it can happen in a church service. Not so much for me. I get too distracted by everything else around me. I'm looking at her hair and this. I have to be alone and hear it. And music can absolutely do that for me. But I just ask you to question your own heart and talk to it, not in a convicting way, but in an encouraging way. Heart, come on. Let's just let God know how much we love him. Let's worship him today. Okay? Keep going. We're going to do some.
4.
Keep an eye on your ankles afterwards.
2.
Thank you.
support, okay?
Lean back.
Oh, my soul.
Never.
sun's rose.
Spine lifts. You guys can turn and face me if you want. That's easier.
Lay down your burden.
knowing that I can come as I am. I'm not one to pretend and put on a mask and dress myself up too often. So he says, come as you are. It's kind of funny when we think we can hide our past from him. Like, he created you. He created every hair in your head. He knows everything you've done and will do. Pull to the side. You can't hide it from him. So go to him with it. Talk to him about it. Other side. You guys did so good today.
That was hard. It was a hard class.
That was hard.
It was good though.